I've not shut up since I met him. We're just going back and forth. He is a social media king, LGBTQ advocate, New York Times best-selling author, and now he can be seen on The Amazing Race for the second time. Please welcome Tyler Oakley. Hi, Tyler.
Hello.
Hi, Tyler.
Good to see you.
Hi, friends.
Morning.
Thank
morning.
You. Good morning.
So, okay, you get the call, right? And they call and they go like, well, they said to you what?
You want to come back?
And that's not an easy answer.
No, it is the hardest thing I have ever done. And so to say, yeah, let's do it again. But it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Twice for you.
Twice in a lifetime. And so many contestants would give anything to go back. So
right.
Corey and I, my partner, we were like, you know what? Let's try this again. And this time, let's get first.
Okay, because you came in third. And do you have a different strategy? And how do you strategize going in? It's already taped, so you can't give anything away.
Right. No spoilers. But we learned a lot the first time. Mm-hmm. We learned that it is so much more running than you think. Yeah. And you are running with 50 pounds on your back.
You look like you're in pretty good shape, though.
I wasn't the first time. So I did a lot of training coming into the second time knowing, like, you know what? I'm not wasting a month and not coming home with $1 million.
Right.
So.
But so it's already I'm always fascinated by it. It's already taped. So he knows who the winner is. Your boyfriend does not. Your parents don't. Your 12 siblings, by the way.
No one knows. Wait.
Nobody knows.
Siblings.
No, because it's more fun when everyone thinks you're going home every week and everyone's on the edge of their seat. And I'm like, well, you might want to watch. This might be the last week.
Do they watch you really carefully? Like, I would.
They're
be
watching
like,
me and they're watching the show and they're like watching to see.
Right.
But yeah, it's so fun to relive it because it was a year ago when we filmed it.
Right. Wow.
And so not only to see what we did, but to see what all the other contestants were up to, what the other challenges were.
Where were you? Where were you shooting?
All over the world.
He can't
all
say,
over
right?
The world.
He can't say?
We've been to, I mean, so far on this season, we have traveled to Dubai, Japan, Uganda,
wow.
Switzerland.
Right.
Out of all the places, and you can mention, what's one of your favorite places to go to?
Oof. I mean, to be able to travel to Uganda, it was breathtaking. Mm-hmm. And to meet the people there, I mean, the best part is going to these cultures and really diving in and meeting the locals. You're not going to the tourist spots. You're going right to where the locals are and doing what the locals do. So, yeah, it's incredible.
So this show actually features all-star players from previous seasons and from Big Brother and Survivor. So these are not fresh off the farm, right? These are not novices.
Right.
This is like Hunger Games when they took the pros back. How does that change the dynamic? You have to up your game even more.
Oh my gosh, yeah. I mean, from the Amazing Race contestants that came back, so many of them were in their own finales but didn't win.
Right.
And so for all of us, this felt like, okay, girl, you need to step it up. This is your last chance to win one of these. And for the Big Brother contestants, the Survivor contestants, they are the type of players that are a little bit more schemey and a little bit more alliance-driven.
Right.
And so that adds a whole new dynamic to it.
Absolutely. So it was interesting. I was reading this article that at one point, you interviewed for this job at Google, and you probably really wanted it, but you didn't get it.
The rumors are true, yeah.
And then, like, it's one of those things where there's a reason for everything, or there's a silver lining. Do you kind of feel that way about that opportunity?
Well, it was my dream job to work at Google, and I thought, you know, when I was in college, I was like, this is it. This is, like, I know everything about it. I'm doing all these interviews. I'm totally going to get this job. I got the no, and it was a blessing in disguise. I went on to graduate, and when I wasn't finding what I thought was my version of success, I was also succeeding on YouTube. And so then when it was all stars aligned, I went full-time YouTube, and now it's kind of like I work for Google. Google owns
That's
YouTube.
Exactly right.
It all kind of worked out in its own way.
Before, real quick, I gotta go to, can we go to the thought real quick? I'm sorry, can we go to the, okay, here's the thought. I talked to you so much, we have to go to the thought now.
Sure.
Good job, Ty.
The technique is get it done. If there was technique, I did not have it. I think if you want to know what the technique was, ask Becca, because we looked over at her and she looked as happy as a clam. Just doing this, she's giggling away, having her life.
And on that farm, I had a side, E-I-E-I-O.
Meanwhile, I'm like over here, like sweating, disgusting, looking like,
oh, my back.
I would not be surprised if she's like, spent a summer doing this, haymaking.
You know what, you still even have good hair.
Thank you.
Yeah.
My main concern around the world, I'm like, how's this look?
It's looking good.
Thank you,
Tyler, you're so lovely.
Of course.
You can catch Tyler and his teammate on The Amazing Race. That is Wednesdays on CBS. Thank you, Tyler.
Thank you, Tyler.
Thank you so much.